Hey y'all, I am using the acrylic sheet bender for bending quarter inch acrylic, and I figured I'd just take this opportunity to show you how I am using it. So we have this guy here set up on the table. It has a heating element running right down the middle. It is very, very hot. Do not touch it. There's a power switch over on this side, and conveniently located underneath the tool, that little guy is the thermostat. So I just have it turned all the way up. It spent maybe 20 minutes heating up, and now the acrylic is getting warm. This is pretty thick stuff, so it's taking a little while to heat up. I'm just gonna go fill this pitcher with more ice water, which we're gonna use to cool it when it's done. All right, so I got some cold water that we're gonna use to set it once it is, once you want it to cool in place. Thinner material, you might not need to do that, but for this we do. So I have some clamps here. I have a piece of wood holding the material so that I can just lift this up and bend it right along this line. So I'll do that in a minute, and then I'll pause the camera so I can reorient it into a position where I can put water on it. We definitely don't want to put water on here, so I'm going to move it somewhere else to do that. So the plastic is definitely ready, so you can just like whoop. Just like magic, fold it up, and now I'm gonna take the clamps off. So I have the plastic down here just to use the leg of the chair as a 90 degree so it stays in that position. And then I'm just gonna put some cold water on it. It's gonna harden up right in that position. Optimally, we would get the cold water on both sides because it's gonna contract on the side that cools. So I'm just gonna not worry about the floor right now and put some of the cold water on both sides. So I'm doing the other side now, and just a few other notes are it's important to not have the paper on when you're doing the heating, because it'll just goop right into it and potentially catch fire, so you don't want that. And it's supported out on this side, which depending on your piece may or may not be necessary. You could probably freehand some things. In this case, it's so big that I just want to have this guide to fold up against. But here's this nice 90 degree bend in this big old sheet of acrylic. So I hope this was useful. Have a good one.